Hello, everybody, and welcome to the tub. Yada, yada, yada. We have a big show planned for today. Don't we?
I have someone
help me out here, guys. I felt really alone there for a second. We have a cast of superstars. Maui superstars here with our show-a-rooney today. The tub never settles for just the mediocre. No, we always go for the very, very best on Maui, like Michael McCartney. Yeah. Yes.
That's mediocre McCartney.
Tanya Teal. Yeah. Kimo Nevius.
Kimo.
And over on this side of the table, let's go with sweet Mama D.
Yeah.
Good to have her here as always. And of course, JoJo Abella, the greatest producer on the island. And Sonny Dennis!
The real reason we're all here!
I cannot believe we got the Sonny with us today. Absolutely thrilled to be here with this tub. You know, sometimes I get excited about the tub. Other times I don't get that excited. I just say, yeah, it's just another tub, you know. But this tub, for some reason, I think it's because it's
I think
sunny.
It's me.
I think it's because it's
sunny. I'm feeling about that.
Yeah, because you're always not thrilled when they're with the Chino episodes.
I love anybody who will show up on time, JoJo. And then was it subtle? I didn't think it was that subtle. No, I'm just so excited that you just flew in, a day and a half ago?
Day and a half ago.
Yeah. Wow. And to be able to be on the tub,
it's hard to be on the tub no matter what the circumstances are.
You know, that's not where
He's
I was going
it.
With
Praise
that.
Praise me regardless.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
We did have a pool running if he would get arrested. Yeah. Before showing up to today's show.
Remember when he got arrested and he was
trying to leave the island?
Do you remember?
He tried. I got away.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. He had to leave. He
you
had to go
to fly
from.
Back we'll talk. Though, did you?
I mean, I technically have a warrant right now, but.
Oh,
let's just broadcast that, shall we?
Really?
Come and get me, MPD.
You know, this is a TV and radio show, right?
They don't do their job, trust me.
Okay, just so everybody will know, this is our 233rd. Tub show.
233.
That's a lot of shows. That's a lot of shows. First of this year, of course, and on TV and on. What happened?
We better bless this with some New Year's, you know, fruit. It's such a tradition, right?
You brought fruit.
We bless things with fruit here.
Yeah.
Welcome to Maui.
It's got to be a Maui thing because I've never done this in any other place. No, we've got cookies and stuff over there. We've got ribs and stuff for later on. Tanya, it's good to have you here.
Thank you.
Tanya,
good to be here.
Tanya, our Canadian lover. And, you know, you've had a baby since
we
talked. Get right up to your microphone.
I did.
Yeah. And that baby is as cute as a bug's ear. I've never liked bug's ears, but
they smell too.
Yeah, my problem is I've had so many babies, and I have so many grandchildren that.
Are you bragging right now?
No, I'm
not a contest, Larry.
This is
big
mourning.
Time, yeah,
this I'm
like,
mourning
like,
right now. I'm in mourning that just another baby doesn't do anything for me. But since it's your baby,
that's right.
It's special.
That's good. Very special. From Maui Rental Babies. I'm glad you like her.
What was that phone number? 808.
Yeah.
I had it in my head.
Get a babe. All right. McCartney, tell everybody exactly where they can find us other than this TV show.
You can reach us on Twitter at @TheLarryJohn or follow us on a tattoo on the back of Sonny Dennis on Facebook at Tub TV and Radio. Yeah, we tried that joke earlier. It didn't go well.
Yeah.
Watch Tub TV and Akaku Channel 55. And you can go online to MauiTVandRadio.com where you'll find all of Maui's best TV and radio shows. That's not bragging.
No, it's not.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe a little.
Listen to Larry John in the Tub on KAKU.
88.5. The Tub.
Oh, my God. My ears just blew
out. Or find us on TuneIn at The Tub Radio Station.
Right.
And find Larry John on the Tub on SoundCloud.
SoundCloud. Be there.
Has SoundCloud been bought yet by Spotify? Do we know?
Again?
Just too much. Can I just say that's too many places to see this shit.
And, you know, nobody goes there anyway. We're lucky to get two people watching, and that's usually me and my wife, you know. So there you go. But anyway, we're still doing it. Have a lot of shows going on, and we'll talk about that later.
Well, before we even move on, I have to ask you, do you feel naked?
Do I feel naked?
This is the first show you don't actually have a board in front of you. You're just sitting here with a
There's a lot of my nakedness here. I actually almost moved the board here.
Okay. You did.
I almost did because of the nakedness thing. Not because I need to work the board, but I just felt like, oh man, this is me out here in front with everybody.
Yeah, it's your blankie. It felt good.
And I don't want to.
Boxers.
Yeah, so. I want a little distance between
nice
you.
Nice socks. Okay.
Yeah. Who needs pants when I have a table here? All right, finding out about you and what you're doing, we're going to start out with that. You can do it quickly, except for you, Sonny.
No.
You cannot do anything fast today, because I don't get you every single month. So you can talk as much as you want.
Take it nice and slow.
Yeah.
Nice.
Real slow.
Can we get some moonlighting?
Moonlighting, please.
So, Sweets, what's new in your life and the blues and the women show you've got going on?
Well, right now the Women Matters, we're doing Women's March. The ladies that are here on Maui that will be marching on the 21st, and a lot of the women that will be going to Washington themselves, and they are letting
March
everyone
March represents
know.
What?
The Women's March on Washington.
Yeah, but what is that all about? I don't
you
get
You know,
it.
I've gotten several different answers to that.
Well, give me one.
One.
Yeah. Is it a positive march or is it a negative march?
What Depends on who you ask.
Yes, that's all.
And I had them all in my office the other day. they decided that we want to march for our rights to have children, our right to say what we can have done to our bodies and by whom and when, which is fine.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
And I'm hoping that they come up with the idea that maybe there ought to be a bill. Maybe if you want to change the law or take one back, do something. Don't just let this fall all over the place after it's over and say, okay, we marched. Fine. What are you going to do after that?
Aren't they doing a march here on Maui?
Yes,
though?
They are on the 21st.
All around the block.
All around the
That's
block.
That's about it, right?
At college.
The college at Maui, beginning at 8 a.m. They will have a moment of silence. That shall coincide with all the moment of silence across the nation.
So this is mainly a protest. Is that what it is?
Yes, mainly a protest. And
protest
I'm
to what?
A protest to
what could be? What might happen?
What will have happened the day before this?
Get right
we
up
all want to know. We all want to know.
We know what's going to happen the day before.
The protest.
Okay, what else is going on with your professional entertainment life?
Well, for right now, we're trying to find a new venue. Hello, we need a new venue for the Blues Jam.
Yeah, good luck.
Blues Jam.
It's hard to find.
They're hard to find right now. But in the meantime, I'm writing music and getting ready to do some stuff.
You're writing music?
I do that sometimes.
I didn't know this.
Surprise.
Man,
you're
that's
a terrible
cool. Yeah, you're like you.
You're a musician that writes music.
Wow. Not only do I write, I also perform it, but that's a whole nother issue.
You're not supposed to do that. You don't make it big if you write your own music.
Come Darn the luck. I give it away most of the time, actually, but, you know, that's okay, too.
All right, let's move over to JoJo. JoJo Abella. JoJo Abella and Poi Dog Productions TV. And your latest stuff is just marvelous. Marvelous stuff, but you got to put it on YouTube so I can put it on our on our website. What the hell's wrong with you? Yeah, you're not getting there. You know? And you know, every time we do one of these shows, you say, "Yeah, I'll do that." But you never do that.
And you wonder why he shows up late.
Right. It's Maui time, you know, Maui
time.
But you can find Poi Dog TV on Facebook or YouTube.
Yeah. That's good stuff. Yeah. Now, the other day, Kimo texted me and said, JoJo Abella, does he happen to work someplace else besides Poi Dog Productions? And I said, yes. And you saw him, but you didn't realize it was him, right?
No, I did not see him because he called in sick that
day. Oh, yeah. Let's not talk about that.
I was there.
Hey, fallacy, I see.
Was that the day where you had the runs?
Were you really sick?
I was... Yeah,
this is TV, you know. So you better.
No, I know.
Right.
Yes.
Very.
Temperature of 104.
All right.
Oh yeah. Oh, poor baby.
All right. So JoJo, we're proud of you, superstar as you are, and McCartney, Michael McCartney. You have some changes that have happened in your life.
You talk about the operation.
I wasn't, but now I'm more interested in that.
Is that why you're growing out your hair?
Yeah, no. I was talking about you're doing, you're not on afternoons anymore. You're doing nights, right? Or you're back on afternoon.
On Coney. On Coney. Yeah. I'm doing afternoons on My 100.7 with this young lady.
Yeah. Yay. Yeah. Yay. Yeah, you guys sound good, too. You sound good. Now you're in Canada when you do this show.
Yes, that's right, but we make it work.
You're sitting right next to me, so you're here right now.
Star Canadians taking our jobs.
Taking our jobs.
Yeah.
Taking our jobs.
But it sounds like I'm here all the time.
No, yeah. No, it sounds incredible. It's really good. And you're on other stations, too, many other stations.
I'm a radio slut. Yes, Larry, we've gone over this before.
All right. Radio slut.
Actually, I was just talking about this the other day, how he made me one.
Yeah. He made you a slut.
It's all his
fault. She's on five stations, too, now. So.
Oh, wow. Go, girl.
This conversation's going downhill really fast. Really fast. Okay.
Here, throw
anyway, so what are you doing in your life other than trying to raise a child?
Wow.
And doing a radio show full-time and the whole thing.
Nothing right now besides, taking care of her and the radio stuff because, I've got the year off work.
This is your first child, right?
Yes, yes.
And it's pure hell, isn't it?
Well, she can be challenging, but she's actually a really great
baby. It has nothing to do with her. It has everything to do with babies. It's just pure hell to raise a kid.
Well, it's a lot of work, yeah.
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 They're
no, it's... It's more than a lot of work. It's frustrating. You find yourself yelling at yourself even?
Yes.
Yes. Seriously, moms yell at the babies and say, "I can stop it." And then they start yelling at themselves, "Why are you doing that?" "Well, I don't know why I'm doing that." And it's just very hard to be a mom.
It is. It is incredibly hard to be a mom. But,
yeah.
The temporary insanity is worth it,
Aww. Yeah.
But for our American viewers, I think it's important what she said about having a year off.
Yeah.
Because
I was going
the Canadian
there.
Government feels that, yes, there is a lot of insanity for mothers. So they get maternity leave for a year in Canada.
What?
Michael, get back to work. You went on Friday.
Wait a minute. There's an actually.
The
actually. Is that the truth?
We get a year, but no, now we get a year and a half. I just missed it. I just missed the year and a half like a month.
Wow.
Yeah.
You should have held it in.
But yeah, Justin Trudeau has
Can't
made
you
it.
Hold that?
That's biological.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah,
that's fantastic. Yeah. We should all be Canadians, don't you think?
I'm going.
Well, it's excellent.
I could never be that nice, but but we should all be Canadian.
You could be the exception that proves.
I could bring your mic right up to yourself because really I'm about to ask you, and of course I know a little bit more about you than
you
most
should.
People want to. Tell us about all the new songs that you are writing, Kimo.
Well, what I've been working on is trying to write a song a week, which isn't really working out because, I'm not that good. But I'm writing songs about the current state of the politics and current affairs and the orange Cheeto Jesus.
Really uplifting stuff then.
Yeah, and it's all sort of angry. Some of it's funny.
It's funny.
But some of it is really pissed off. About what's about to happen to this country, which is not good.
So tell them some of the titles of the song.
So the one we were working on a couple of days ago is called Puppet, because let's face it, who's pulling the strings here? The one before that was called Let It Go.
You're the puppet.
You're the puppet, exactly. You're the puppet. So what was about his tendency to tweet everything that's on his mind instead of letting it go. The one before that was called Not My President.
I've heard that one on the radio quite a bit.
Yeah, a certain DJ
has played
that song a number of times.
I wonder.
And this one we were working on the other day, Puppet, it needs a little couple of tweaks before it can go out live, but it's a good song.
It's very good.
I'm very pleased
very, very
with this
good.
Song.
Yeah.
Are you looking to have a career with this for the next 4 years?
Correct. A song a week for 4 years.
There you go.
And then we'll compile them into the world's biggest box set and get it out there.
But these songs are very, very good songs. And then you listen to the lyrics and... you're a bitter man.
I got to channel it someplace.
Right.
Take your broken heart and turn it into art.
I love it.
Isn't that what Meryl Streep said the other
day?
Yes,
she did.
Wow.
So there you go.
Yeah. And she said, martial arts.
Yeah,
that's not real arts.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. She needs a roundhouse kick to the head.
Yeah, that right. was in fact a joke, but you know, she delivered it with such seriousness that I don't think anybody laughed.
Okay, I did.
Well, there you go. So Larry
but
laughed.
But I'm nobody.
And Meryl is
right.
Like,
yeah. God, Larry. Not Larry.
All right. Anyway, we're really proud of you. And these songs we're producing now are so much better than when we started. The quality, the...
Yeah, we're getting better every time.
Every time.
And by the time we're done with this, we'll really know
You'll
what
be
we're doing.
Yeah.
Finally.
But these are good songs. And, you know, in the war, there were protest songs for the war.
Yeah, so this is... I'm reviving... This,
yeah, the protest you know, song.
And
yeah.
it's really... it's a it, no one knows who Phil Oakes is anymore except McCartney.
I ain't a marching anymore.
There you go. Mm-hmm. But it's there's a Phil Oakesian quality.
Yeah.
Married to a strong drum beat.
Cool.
Yeah.
I believe Phil Oakes was actually tossed out of Bob Dylan's limousine once.
That's how Phil Oakes told the story.
Yeah.
All right, let's listen to one of Kimo's songs. Here's Kimo Nevius and Not My President.
What is the sound of a world turned upside down? The sound of a people whose hopes have all been drowned. The face of this disgrace is an orange thin-skinned clown. A carnival barker, a tweeting huckster who's bringing the discourse down, down, down. Well, now a revolution has begun. Like a bullet that can't go back into the barrel of a smoking gun. Our eyes were shut before, I'm sure, now they're open wide. Go build your dam, your fence, your wall, 'cause you're never gonna stem the tide. Oh, and I, oh, I, oh, I, this is my descent. Oh, I, oh, I, president, he's not my president. He stokes the fires of fear and dread. Said he could step out on Fifth Avenue and just shoot somebody dead. But were all his promises just empty veiled threats? IOUs to his faithful, and he's never gonna pay them debts. Just like, oh, just like all these other unpaid bills. Just like all his slogans unfulfilled. Just like a confidence man that does it all for thrills. Well, he's not my president. He's not my president. People are marching in the streets, and the other side wonders, hey, why aren't you generous in defeat? Not when I find swastikas painted on a classroom door. Not when my friends are wondering what the country's falling for. Oh, I, oh, I, oh, I, oh, I. No, I will not relent. No, I, no, I, no, this is my descent. No, I, no, I, he's not my president. He's not my president. He's not, He's not my president. He's not. He's not. He's not my president. He's not.
All right, now let's move ahead to Boston.
Boston. Let's go to Beantown with Wicked Sonny Dunham. Awesome.
Okay, so here's my question. I follow you on Facebook, obviously. I don't know if that's
Do
obvious.
You?
I follow
he likes
a little. And,
like 2 in the morning
You and Pauline.
Yes.
Sometimes, all
it's
the time.
It's a weird time to like my pictures, that's all I'm saying. Glad you're thinking of me, but
you know, he's sitting in his boxers, maybe.
too much.
Like. Oh, thank you.
Daddy like.
And, no, I, of course, I follow you and Pauline there. And but I have a real question. Boston. Why Boston? I mean, it's such a terrible place.
It is, definitely. But when I was six, they have the Pro Bowl that takes place in Hawaii every year. And they have a clinic where like players would come to the schools and go, oh, let's show you how to do drills. And Ty Law, who was a cornerback for the New England Patriots, was the cool, he taught me like a black eye handshake, and it was awesome. So I'm like, I don't know who you play for, I don't even watch football, but I'm
Wait
doing that next year.
This is the reason you went to Boston?
I am a diehard Patriots fan.
Really?
Like, it's in
well, then
my
you
soul.
you gotta be hurting right now, right?
Why? This is the, we're gonna win another, this is ridiculous.
I don't think so.
Also, we're not talking about the Mel Gibson movie.
I don't think
so.
We're talking football.
You think the Patriots are going to go all the way? No way.
Why?
What? What?
What's in the way?
Uh-oh.
The Cowboys.
That's a big what's in the way.
Oh,
you know?
Okay. I'm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's
no.
Hear
see,
that again.
Our family.
Well, when this show rebroadcasts in February, everyone will look foolish.
Yeah.
I'll hold
I don't
the
care.
Money.
We don't care. But for now.
And the Red Sox too. They got a spot in my heart as well. Okay. And Casey Affleck, for some reason.
Well,
that's the Boston.
Ben is overrated.
Way too much information.
I know. I've been working on it. Yeah.
No, but our family, we're all Cowboy fans.
Yeah.
You know, we're from Arizona, and that's as close as we can get because the Cardinals were crap, you know. And so
bandwagoners, man.
Yeah, for sure. And what?
Like, yeah, they had a great
but
season.
That was so last year. What's my so wife talking bad. During the show?
What have the Cowboys done in 15 years besides
producer.
Suck and lose in new creative ways?
Oh, yeah.
Every year it's, oh, what's Tony Romo going to do?
Yeah.
Break his hip and die on the way to the game.
No.
Tony he said Tony Romo, I'm thinking of ribs.
He's not playing.
I know.
Well, then what was your point?
The last 15 years of being a Cowboys
man.
Fan.
Yeah. Well, we
25. What am I saying?
We can agree to disagree.
No, I'm right. You're just wrong.
I hate that. I hate that worse than any other thing.
Oh, my God. The show is now going to be officially canceled.
Okay, so Boston, how's it treating you?
It's a love-hate thing.
Yeah,
I was born and raised in Hawaii. I'd never really been anywhere else.
Yeah.
So it's like my first taste of a city, first taste of like cold weather, first taste of mean people.
And it's so cold.
Yeah, but being cold's not that bad.
It's that bad.
You just, if you're prepared for it, you got a good jacket, you got good boots, it's nothing.
So you had to buy a whole
wardrobe. But it's like people just want to complain about anything. Same thing with over here. The sugar cane's getting in my yard. And it's snowing and I got to try this. They plowed the thing. Shut up. It's no matter where you are, life is beautiful.
Yeah.
So
how was the flight over? Was it really just delightful?
I hate Virgin Airlines.
I know.
I love Virgin Airlines. I was the complete opposite because it was like going into a nightclub.
Dude, they have the 6-minute long like music video of safety features and stuff like that. Put your nips on. You got to do dance moves with it. And this will be just a plane full of dead dancing people at the bottom of the ocean somewhere. And it will be DJ Jackie Jeff, or who I don't even know the guy. It's his fault. Okay. And TSA. I just blame them.
I flew it just once, and it was just last year, and I was just surprised because you're walking down. What do they call that accordion thing that goes out to the plane?
Bridge.
Yes, the bridge.
Yes.
So I'm walking along it, and it's just lined with what looks like Richard Branson's favorite surfer girls ever. They're all wearing blue jeans and just a t-shirt.
So it's Virgin Airlines on. Then you walk in, and it's like a nightclub, right? It's all red.
Now, you were saying they tried too hard to be cool, right?
It's like, there were pictures.
Yeah.
It's, you know, there were pictures on the Italian thingy.
And Chris Hardwick was on his Nerdist podcast was what was offered to listen. I loved it all.
But you said you didn't dig that. You didn't.
Well,
dig
no, they were really millennial about everything.
About
so when
everything.
It's like, yeah, you know, like, give me this paper. I need a pen. Well, you should have a pen. Like, you're at work right now. Jesus. And so you're a flight attendant too. How dare you give me attitude? Like, you're just you're a glorified waitress in the sky. It's
Well, now has your career blossomed there as a comedian?
Oh God, no. But it's I'm performing in garages and like basements and like yards.
You don't go on last though, right?
Oh no, on a real show I usually do, but or first, which is worse by far, but. It's I'm getting better. I'm definitely putting in the work, and it's paying off.
Are you funny yet?
Yeah, it took me I had to figure that out. Yeah. I was like, oh, I might have made a huge mistake here for the first month. And it worked out. I'm becoming the, I'm just the Hawaii guy, the Hawaii guy in the scene.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You're hanging on to us.
Our, you Arizona, okay, back it off there.
Back off.
Howley boy over here.
But you're hanging on you're kind of like, what was your partner's name? Chino? What was
it? Yeah.
How quick we forget.
That hack.
he went West Coast. Right. It's an East Coast versus West Coast thing now.
West Coast is easy.
So are there gigs? Because a lot of famous comedians come out of Boston.
Oh, yeah. I've performed at a bunch of spots, like Louis C.K.'s old. I did a spot there every week. I got to open up for a couple YouTube quality comedians where they have a bunch of followers on YouTube, but I've never seen them or heard who they are, but it was still good shows. I got paid three different times for comedy.
Okay,
Now we're talking.
Three different times?
I know, in a year and a half. I made it, guys.
So you could use that money to go to Dunks, right?
We're gonna have to take a break.
We'll talk,
McCartney, if you read that, we're gonna take a short little break and we'll be back right after this.
Remember, you can watch and listen to all of our Larry John productions at MauiTVandRadio.com. Shows like Hotel Balderdash, Maui's Kids Show.
I love to turn on my TV, laugh and have fun. Hotel Balderdash, it's the only one. Hotel Balderdash.
Get ready for Better.
Hey, everybody!
Oh, right here, buddy.
Oh, my.
How are you?
Great to be here.
Yeah, great to see you.
I'm Homeless Benny.
Yeah.
How this?
Yeah.
He's a nice coat, my good man.
Nice, huh?
Very nice coat.
Very, huh?
How are you doing? So, who wants to hear a song?
A song!
On exhibit with Bill Best, Maui's premier art show.
We're talking with the executive director of the Hui Noiau Visual Arts Center, Carolyn Kilauer. How are you doing?
Great, thank you. Welcome to the Hui Noiau.
A Maui music moment with Rondo Rosebond. Interviews with Maui's best musicians. Tub TV and Radio, Maui's Hot Talk.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Tub. Yada, yada, yada. We have a big show planned for today, don't we? Help me out here, guys.
And new on radio, working for you with Eric Molina. A collection of interviews spotlighting Maui's nonprofit organizations working hard for the people of Maui. Let's do three breaks.
We're back. Let's not. I have a situation.
Uh oh. We're getting cream for that now.
As I get older and older.
Oh, I got a cream for you. Well, I got some ointment.
I don't know why I like you. I have no idea why I like you. Okay. Anyway, as I get older and older, I look for friends who are older than I am. Because it's easy to be young. It's easy to be young. You can be young. You can be healthy. You can be all of these things.
Look at this table.
Hey.
Show me how easy it is then, Larry.
It's hard to be old. It's hard to be old, even though I enjoy being old. Who was I talking about this to the other day? Oh, Eric Molina. I really enjoy it because the pressure's off. I don't have to worry about the money and the accomplishments and am I going to make it and all of those things.
Costco's out of adult depends.
Yeah. Just depends. And but it's always fun to have friends who are older than I am. And this week, Carl turns 70 years old.
Big 7-0.
Our producer, Carl Rosiski.
I'm sensing a roast.
Yes. Actually, I don't know if we can announce the party. It'll be over by the time this gets on the air anyway. Anyway, we're going up there to see a bunch of pictures that his dad took, which are incredible. No, not just good, but he took them back in the 50s and went. He was a professional
photographer.
What is it? Yeah, but a publicist kind of photographer. And Sweets is going to be singing later on. I told Carl, there's a gig.
Hey, Sweets.
Well, good. It doesn't matter to me. So from 5 to 7, we're watching pictures and doing all these things. But from 7 to 10, we're doing a gig. I mean, we're playing. We're party on. And the band is playing, not my band, but the band is playing. And aren't you playing for that?
Sure, I will.
Yeah, well, no. Comes as a surprise. Well, Carl told me you were playing.
Maybe.
And Michael asked me, well, how long are you going to stay? You know, how long are you going to stay? And I said, I'm going to stay until they don't let me sing anymore.
Michael asked that.
Yeah,
but Michael asked that question like she wasn't going. Like, how long are you going to stay?
We are going.
She didn't say we.
We're going. Would you get that camera off of me?
The decider.
Okay. No,
decider, not a divider.
Now, Carl's going to ask me to sing, right? Yeah. Carl said that I would be singing all the songs, so Kimo don't come.
I don't want to sing Mustang Sally again.
Mustang Sally.
You're brushing up on your Adele.
Yeah. All right, you asked me, but Carl, congratulations, 70 years. Our producer, and of course...
That's the combined age of everyone at this table.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Except for Larry.
Thanks. Okay.
No problem, Larry.
So
Bear.
Anyway, let me get this out. I save the best stuff so nobody can see it. I save it right here. And one of my most fun... What's that?
You thought I didn't see it? I saw it.
Did you? Okay.
I'm looking at it right now.
One of my favorite things to do, I'm running my own audio. I can't believe this. One of my favorite, can you hear that?
Yeah, what
yodeling,
is this?
Yodeling.
Yodeling, all right.
All right.
What's the Price is Right game with the yodeler?
All right, stop. I said stop.
Bouncing a button.
I knew if I started my own audio.
This is live, folks. You can't do anything about this.
The weirdest.
Well, Lair Bear tries to fix that. Yeah. Let's all pose for a photograph.
In the meantime,
I had this rehearsed so well. Okay, so
made good use of that time.
Kimo, you do this better because McCartney refuses to do
it. I understand that.
And this is
just the headlines.
Yeah, it's a feature that we do that I love, and I think I'm the only guy who likes this.
No, Kimo loves
but
news.
These are actual headlines. We don't know the stories.
We don't know the stories.
We
so
have
this
we have no idea.
Just the headlines.
Yeah,
I love it. I love it.
Louise. Louisiana man accidentally texted sheriff's deputy about a crystal meth delivery.
Oh, my. How do you accidentally
oops.
Do that?
Yeah, that's an oops.
Yeah. Just the headlines.
What did you do with my bell, by the way?
We hit that puppy.
Give me my bell.
You really need your bell?
It's part of
what?
I didn't say it.
Save it for Boulder Dash, man. Jeez.
It started, it ended correctly, but started kind of, funky.
Yeah.
Okay. It's just the headlines. Father convicted of failing to provide necessaries of life for son promotes nutritional supplements in British Columbia.
Yeah.
Oh, those Canadians.
For all those those Canucks.
Knew there'd be problems.
Rebuttal.
Just the headlines. Turkish marriage guide advises wives to wear sexy outfits after being beaten to please their husbands. See, this is why I want to pre-read this.
I
thought better of you, Kimo.
That's terrible.
Don't make fun of this, man.
Next.
In need of sleep, a caller asked Niagara Falls, New York police to, quote, stop the wind from blowing.
Right.
Wow.
Those are similar to service requests here on Maui.
Two sisters are attacked with a hand. Why does he make me read this stuff?
Give it to Sonny.
Two sisters attacked with a hand grenade for refusing marriage proposal. Now, that's just sad.
Yeah.
That's not funny.
I think it's hilarious.
Did they lose a leg? It's a hand grenade. How much damage could it be, really? just the hand.
Just the hand.
Just the hand.
Man barricades himself in a house after family member takes a bite of his grilled cheese sandwich.
No.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, that's not all that story. Then he shot his wife. No, that actually happened.
Yeah, that did. No, it really did happen. Yeah.
Just the headlines. A New York boy, 12, demands chicken nugget at gunpoint.
All right. Oh, someone saw falling down.
Too much Call of Duty.
And last, thankfully, a family is suing Apple because some bozo was using FaceTime while driving and plowed into their car. Ladies and gentlemen,
can you
this
imagine?
It
has to be Apple's fault, right?
It is Apple's fault.
Yeah, because they came up with a program that I was using.
Well, they didn't say don't use it while you're driving.
Well,
you got to let me know.
Remember, you can watch and listen to all of our Larry John productions at MauiTVandRadio.com. Shows like Hotel Balderdash, Maui's Kids Show.
I love to turn on my TV, laugh and have fun. Hotel Balderdash, it's the only one. Hotel Balderdash.
Get ready, Benny.
Hey, everybody!
Oh, right here, Benny.
Oh, my.
How are you?
Great to be here.
Yeah, great to see you.
I'm homeless Benny.
Yeah.
How this?
Yeah.
He's a nice coat, my good man.
Nice, huh?
Very nice coat.
Very, huh?
How are you doing? So, who wants to hear a song?
A song!
On exhibit with Bill Best, Maui's premier art show.
We're talking with the executive director of the Hui Noiau Visual Arts Center, Carolyn Killauer. How are you doing?
Great, thank you. Welcome to the Hui Noiau.
A Maui music moment with Rondo Rosebond. Interviews with Maui's best musicians.
Hava olaji.
Tub TV and Radio, Maui's Hot Talk.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Tub. Yada, yada, yada. We have a big show planned for today, don't we?
Someone
help me
ready
out here, guys.
And new on radio, working for you with Eric Molina, a collection of interviews spotlighting Maui's nonprofit organizations working hard for the people of Maui.
All right, time for us to move on.
Really?
Let's see if this will pause.
Look at that.
Woo! Rocket.
It's coming up Larry.
How many people could do that, huh? Oh, yeah, that's right. Everyone. All right, so we're going to have a little bit of fun. The Tub Fiasco.
Tub Fiasco!
Hey.
Sorry.
The Tub... Do we do it now with everything that we announced?
Why not?
I thought it was just topics.
I'll do myself.
Yeah, I thought it was just topics, too, but I guess not. Tub Fiasco. Now, this is, we've never done this one before. This is kind of fun.
Virgin territory, Tub.
Uh-oh. Yeah. And it's called, and we've kind of gone through some of these questions, but we're going to do it a little bit different because I love true and false. I love true and false. Cause
false.
50% chance of getting it right.
Exactly. Multiple choice. Hate it. But true and false, man, I pass every time. Okay. So what I'm going to do is ask you, before I ask you the question, if the answer is true or false.
Because should be right.
Well, yeah, exactly. Okay. And then people are going to vote whether or not they're correct. Okay.
Before hearing the question.
So if they say,
no,
yes.
I was going to say, yeah.
No, this will work. This will work.
We'll contain ourselves.
Stop it. This is exciting.
All
right. This is exciting. So sweets, first question, true or false?
False.
How many people think the question is going to be false?
It's going to be true.
You got one.
No, I'm not doing
this,
any of them.
Yes.
Humans.
Thank you, Carl.
Scintillating. I'm going to say that it will be false.
Thank you.
Humans can distinguish between over a trillion different smells.
True.
Now, how many people said it was false?
It's false.
I said false.
It's true.
Oh.
Don't doubt the McCartney.
Now, if you voted that it was true, keep score because you could win this little game.
What could it be?
Tangerine.
Just keep track. That's all I'm asking you to do.
Fine.
All right, JoJo.
We're all going to tie. That's what's going to happen.
JoJo, true or false? True or false?
Oh, I got it.
It's you.
Say true or false.
True or false?
F or T.
True.
Okay.
No, you say it's true. How many people say this? No. The question is true.
It's true.
Yeah. I'm going to say it's true.
Yeah. You all say it's true?
I'm sticking with false.
Okay. Twinkies have an infinite shelf life.
Now that is false.
It's false. I'm sorry. You're wrong. And so is everyone else who said that he was. Isn't this game fun?
No. Yeah. No,
this is, what is okay. the opposite
I'm losing.
Of fun?
Yeah.
No. Okay. Let's go with Sonny. Sonny, true or false?
Am I heroin right false? Try false out.
He's going with false. Okay. The top of... Oh, wait.
Whoa.
I say it's true.
Vote how many?
No, I say it's true.
How many say it's false? False. Nobody. You're going to go with false.
I'm going to say false.
You're with Sonny. Okay. The top of the Eiffel Tower leans away from the sun.
Why are you looking at me? You asked the question. Yeah.
I answered
before you asked it.
The answer.
It's true, isn't it?
It's true.
It's true. Of course it is.
Two. Yes. One. All right.
Kimo, okay. True or false?
Say false.
He's going to say false. Everybody say, how many people say it's false?
I'm staying with false.
You're
going to say it's true.
All right. Drinking alcohol kills brain cells.
False.
It is false.
Yes.
Wait, are you excited?
How
because you
this do you have 3 points already?
I have six. I don't know what you're talking about.
Sweet says 80
And I've only asked four questions.
I'm keeping score, okay?
Bonus round.
Like a boss.
Okay, Tanya, true or false?
True.
How many people agree with her?
I agree with her.
Yeah. I say true.
False. She's completely wrong.
Okay.
Toilet pioneer Thomas Crapper.
Oh, yeah.
Name isn't where we get the name crap from.
That is true.
It is true, actually.
It's false.
Yes, I said crapper? False.
Yeah, it's false.
I don't believe
it. We didn't get the name crap from Crapper.
That's too bad.
You said is or isn't where we get the name.
I don't know what
you're talking like Yoda right now, man.
All
over the place.
It isn't where we get the name.
So has that been an urban myth all these years?
For me, it has. I've always thought that was true. But no, it's false. Stop trying.
Did you say it is where we get the name?
Okay.
All right, for those who are watching this on Facebook Live, can you go to your computers and let us know?
It isn't. Okay.
This is the one we're going to argue about for the rest of the year.
Okay. And Carl, do we have time to do more, or do we need to take a break?
No, there's no more time. Done. Wait a minute, that's false.
Give Carl a birthday and look what he does. I'm going to take a break anyway. Would that help? Okay, we're going to take a short break. McCartney, do the voice for that, and we'll be back right after this.
Remember, you can watch and listen to all of our Larry John productions at MauiTVandRadio.com. Shows like Hotel Balderdash, Maui's Kids Show.
I love to turn on my TV, laugh and have fun. Hotel Balderdash, it's the only one. Hotel Balderdash.
Get ready for
Hey, everybody!
Oh, right here, buddy.
Oh, my.
How are you?
To be here.
Yeah, great to see you.
I'm Homeless Benny.
Yeah.
Is a nice coat, my good man.
Nice, huh?
Very nice coat.
Very, huh?
How are you doing? So... Who wants to hear a song?
A song!
On exhibit with Bill Best, Maui's premier art show.
We're talking with the executive director of the Hui Noiau Visual Arts Center, Carolyn Killauer. How are you doing?
Great, thank you. Welcome to the Hui Noiau.
A Maui music moment with Rondo Rosebond. Interviews with Maui's best musicians.
Hava ola ji.
Tub TV and Radio, Maui's Hot Talk.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Tub. Yada, yada, yada. We have a big show planned for today, don't we?
Help
me out here, guys.
And new on radio, working for you with Eric Molina. A collection of interviews spotlighting Maui's nonprofit organizations working hard for the people of Maui.
And welcome back to the Tub. Thank you, everyone, for being here. I want to get back to Sonny. And then I want to go to Tanya because Tanya. No, let's go to Tanya. Tanya.
Oh, that's more interesting.
Where's your baby? I know you brought your baby here today so she could be on television.
So angry about it.
Of course.
I'm angry.
Baby
at. Everyone wants their baby to be famous.
Well, go get her. Go get your baby. Or Michael, bring the baby over here. Please.
This is child exploitation at its highest level.
I said please. Kind of.
Do it now.
Wow. Keyword.
That was about... The baby is about the same age you were when you made your stage debut. Is that correct?
No, I was three. But it's...
I was close.
The... this is where we have to get a close-up so that Carl...
I got a couple.
This, okay, good. This is for later on when she's 13 years old and you can't stand her. And you can look at the footage of this and say...
When that first boy comes over to ask her out for a date. Come inside, I want to show you this video.
So wait a minute.
Yeah, what are videos?
Now,
love the earrings. What, they're so cute. Oh, my God.
Who does she look like? She doesn't look like you, does she?
How does she... Who has a child this young with earrings?
My daughter did.
Really?
And what was your reaction? Go for it, girl, or what are you doing?
Go, girl. Okay. We'll get you some hoops when you're six.
She's from Maui
Okay.
Baby Rentals.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, we come that way.
What's the phone number again for Maui Baby Rentals?
1-800-RENT-A-KID.
Lean into the microphone. Don't knock her head on the table there. And tell me what this kid's name is.
Her name is Hannah Aurora.
Oh, nice. Hannah. So did you name her after Hannah?
I did. Aww. I did.
Really? Yes.
Is that your favorite place on the island or something?
It is my favorite place.
Unbelievable. Wow. Yeah. Do you ever get tempted just to drink
What if that? Albuquerque was your favorite place? Yeah. Would it be Albuquerque Aurora?
Stop it.
Stop it. Des Moines.
Could be.
Des Moines.
Hi, I'm Bismarck. How you doing?
So she's very quiet. Most kids that I know of are... they're not this well-trained. So
you were a poor father? Is that what you're saying?
I was a terrible father.
She's very, very good. Like, the whole time that we flew here, she was quiet, sleeping, just a really good baby.
Are we talking about the baby?
Yeah.
Yeah. Really?
And she loves the microphone. She's always grabbing for the microphone.
Even when you guys are doing your regular
show?
Yeah,
oh, yeah. And she tries to be a part of the show even then.
Really?
All the time. Oh, yeah.
Does she ever start crying during the show?
She does. She's been in the show a few times.
Is that right?
I made her debut.
I'm the one that actually cries most of the time during the show. Larry see me at the movies cry. Yeah, it is.
Well, anyway, hey, Michael, you can come get this baby again. I'm... totally tired
please.
Of her right
there
now.
Was a please in there you just couldn't hear
yeah.
it.
Yeah, it was that silent.
The silent
I said please. I started with please, didn't I?
No.
Didn't
neither sucks.
So anybody who's an official with the child labor laws, talk to Larry John.
Oh, we're under the time
there
mark.
Oh, we are under
child labor laws don't yeah, apply
now,
if it's
you have twins
child,
correct
turns out
smack all him right. around
wait, oh, is that true
I'll wait, for you where
it is now time for another break, but we're not going to take it because we're running out of time. It's time now for Don't You Do That. You see what he's doing here?
We're all going to do it.
It's time now for Tub Topic.
Topics!
Man, I can feel that distortion through my whole head. Oh, that's good. We are, we're going to ask a very simple question, but I want a very complex answer.
Do you love me, Larry?
Tomorrow. I,
Let's play Never Have Over.
This is amazing.
Never. Oh, no.
I'm just playing.
No, you're not.
Now, for some of this, this is a very easy question. So make it hard. For others, it's going to be a very hard question because you never do this. Starting with sweets and going around the table.
Quoting Marshall Crenshaw.
Okay, starting with McCartney and going in the other way because Sweets asked me to. What is your favorite way to waste time?
Am I allowed two answers?
No.
Dear God.
Sure, why not? How can you say
movies
no
and carnal knowledge?
In that
no,
order.
Movies is a waste of time. Wait a minute. I can't let this lie there. Carnal knowledge? How did you mean
I guess
that?
Maybe passing time, maybe not wasting time.
So no, it's wasting time.
Wasting
not
time. Okay, well, then I don't have an answer for you. Tanya?
Wait a minute. You had two.
Yeah.
Stop it. What is your favorite way to waste time? You got to have some.
A nap.
That's not a waste of time.
No. I don't know. I guess I don't waste my time.
But you got it. Here, we'll go to Tanya. We're coming back to you.
I'll listen to what everybody else says.
What an idiot, really. I got two now. I got nothing. Okay, Tanya, waste of time. What is your favorite way to waste time?
Solitaire. Ooh.
Really?
That sounds like pleasure, right?
No, that's wasting time.
It is.
What good could come from
it? It really is. Like, it used to be Minesweeper, but, you know.
Yeah,
well. They don't have
solitaire.
That anymore on the computer.
You know that I've never played solitaire. I wouldn't know how to play solitaire.
Really?
I can teach you.
I don't want to know.
It's a waste of time.
Yeah. 52 pickup. That's more fun.
All right, we may come around a second time. Kimo, who's the busiest guy in the world, what's your favorite way to waste time?
Twitter.
Twitter.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is a waste of time.
Twitter's terrible. It's an awful time suck.
Yeah.
And I don't go on very often, but if I do and I actually start reading the things people post, first it makes me cry out for humanity.
Yeah.
And then it makes me realize, God, what a waste of time that was.
Yeah. Now, do you like humans?
False.
Pass.
They're not the best animal.
You know, I've always said I like people if it weren't for the humans. You know, but it's you like people.
I like people, but I also like, you know, the absence of people.
Yeah,
I like people in the abstract, just not like always being with them.
The idea of people.
Your baby's crying. Can't use the tub. That's a waste of time.
I smoke weed.
Now, see, I wouldn't see that as a waste of time. But.
Said the felon.
That's no difference than me shooting like
it is illegal in the state of Massachusetts now.
Is
recreationally,
it?
Yeah.
Really?
Suck it, Hawaii.
Where's your card? Yes.
I don't need a card. It's recreationally.
You
just walk into a store and get it.
Wow.
You can have an ounce on you at all times. You can have 10 ounces at your house.
Wow.
It's pretty good year for me.
You know, I've...
Trump won, but I also got to vote for that.
We finally know why you're in Boston now, then, right?
It wasn't legal. I'm the reason it's legal.
Yeah,
I got there and I voted. I voted, man. It felt good.
You know, I've never had any marijuana. I've never had any weed.
Oh, let's hang out this weekend. Go to Hana.
Can I take pictures? Larry to Hana.
There's a part
we'll all watch him smoke weed.
There's a part of me that would really like to do that.
Yeah.
And there's another part of me that goes, no! I'm like, I can't do that. I've waited too long. I mean, you know, I'm old.
Oh, your brain's developed. This is the time to do it. It's like, it's mushy, so. Yeah. If not, then you get it's moldable. You know what I mean?
It's pliable.
Oh, tomato, tomato.
Let's go, Joe.
Tuesday.
Joe.
Favorite waste of time?
Your favorite waste of time.
Here it comes.
Netflix and chill.
Now, see, how come he gets away with Netflix and I don't get away with movies?
I don't think he should get away with it.
Because you watch a lot of Netflix.
Oh, yeah.
What do you love it?
What do you watch? What
so
you're
the
watching, though?
Here is if Larry does it, it's not a waste of time.
See, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Like, if you're watching The Big Bang Theory on Netflix, that is a waste of time. Mm. House of Cards, you can argue either way. Like, you're getting something out of it.
Or Fuller House.
It's a waste of time.
When I'm watching, if I'm watching television, it's not a waste of time.
What's your jam right now, Larry?
My jam?
What are you into on television?
Did he say jam?
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Here it comes.
Uh-oh.
He's got a list.
Housewives.
His favorite
Housewives.
Shows. Housewives of Haiku.
Yikes.
Okay, I need my wife.
You've never seen The Wire,
you're
which
getting ready for Suits
still.
To come back. I know that.
We have about 30 shows that we record.
You know Orange is the New Black is terrible too, right?
I don't watch that anymore.
Good. All right, yeah, that's why I like it.
I watched it the first couple of seasons, and I don't like it at all. But we have about 30 shows that we record.
Gothic.
And what's that?
Gothic,
absolutely. Is my wife yelling stuff down the stairway?
Correct.
On the floor. She's on the floor.
Yeah, that would be one. Does anybody watch that?
I don't even know what that is.
Yeah, it's good. It's very good.
Oh, Kids Say the Darndest Things?
Is that the one with Billy Bob Thornton?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
He just won a Golden Globe for that.
Yes, he did.
And it was excellent.
Do Westworld. It's what's up.
When we tried it, we couldn't do it. I didn't like it.
Really?
Too much nudity. No,
yeah, I get it. Don't do Game of Thrones either.
Almost lost it. Almost saw a friendship get severed right there.
But JoJo, yeah. JoJo, give me something really a waste of time.
Call of Duty.
Oh, you play video games?
Video games.
It's hand-eye coordination, though.
So.
Yeah, that is a
video
waste of time.
How is video games a waste of time versus you watching 30 shows on TV every week?
I don't play video games.
Again, back to the definition.
All right, sweet. So what did you come up with, waste of time?
Bold moves, Oprah Winfrey's bold moves.
I really don't know what
is that a book?
See? No, it's a little video game.
Well, talking about a waste of time, thank
Again,
you for
depend,
wasting your time here on the tub. We've had a lot of fun. Thank you for being
thank
here.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, my God.
It's better without the computer screen here. Blocking
yeah, that's kind
of yeah.
Well, make love to the camera one last time.
That's Sonny Dennis. Want to thank him for being here. Of course, JoJo Abella.
All the kids watching the tub.
Sweet Mama D.
Sweet Mama D.
Michael McCartney.
Mediocre McCartney.
Tanya Teal. And, of course, Kimo.
Yeah.
This has been our
Angry Kimo
January tub. It will be playing on Akaku 55. It'll be also on
K-85. The tub.
So be with us next time. Say goodbye, everyone. Goodbye.
Goodbye, everyone. Peace out, homies.
Peace out.